Hello, and welcome back to Assassin's Creed Syndicate. Last episode we tore through Whitechapel, and this episode we shall tour through the City of London. And we are 99% complete with this game. It's all up to whether or not it has those helix glitches that didn't load in. So I'm gonna check the map real quick. I'll wait for it to load. And it doesn't look like it has them, unfortunately. Either that or I'm completely missing them, but no, I don't see them at all. So it looks like we're gonna be staying at 99%. So last episode we toured through Whitechapel, and this episode we shall be going through the City of London. Let's start in this corner right here. City of London is probably the largest borough other than Westminster. I mean, yes, the Thames might be technically longer, but it's not quite as wide, and the majority of it isn't even really all that significant. Like, I could probably mix it in with the City of London, Westminster, Lambeth, whatever. Like before, this isn't going to be a particularly action-packed episode by any stretch. Sorry there. Any stretch of the imagination.
Don't jump, jump. Don't be shy. You'll not find iron.
We're just going around and. Oh, now you decide to run? And seeing all the animations. The animations and the audio clips that you might otherwise miss going through the game normally.
We'll wait a bit, just to be sure. Another glove. There we are.
Thank you, darling.
My pleasure.
Join me in the spring. I've seen a deal of gaiety throughout my noisy life. With all my grand accomplishments, I never get a wife. The thing I most excel in is the VR every day. A noise all night, in bed all day. And swimming in champagne,
just try and listen to music, damn it.
What is it?
Archie! Dash the summer guitar.
She looks so dead inside.
I could really make a difference.
Why don't you?
Why don't I what?
Stand for Parliament. Didn't you say someone was resigning?
Yes, or...
Thomas, was it?
Yes.
You could stand in his place.
It's a lovely thought, my little schemer, but I doubt I would even gain the nomination.
You should do it.
Well, that's very nice of you, dear, but it would mean spending far too much time away from you.
Oh, Steven.
In your red.
It appears we both have our pleasant bits.
Starry,
oh,
sunny,
cheeky bugger!
I'll get you for that.
Where did you get that dress?
Oh, Ryan, this old thing?
Very fetching on you, my love.
Police overwhelmed by vicious criminals.
Well now, aren't you just the most charming fella?
Only for you. You bring it out of me.
You like me new dress?
Let me see. Yes, I reckon.
There's no need for that.
Oh, you see, it caught me snooping.
From your area.
Sometimes it takes a few tries.
I've no patience for this.
I apologize, sir.
And don't do it again.
Immediately, sir.
First you cut off the end, and then you wait for all the blood to drain out.
I don't know what came over me, sir.
This is the last straw.
Of course, but...
Do I make myself understood?
Perfectly, sir. Oh.
This isn't the first time you've been cut away from your area.
Sometimes it takes a few tries.
I've no patience for this.
I apologize, sir.
Do I make myself understood?
Again, I'm trying to avoid being in that, like, state where there's a circle around and some of their body is highlighted, because they will eventually stop talking before they finish their dialogue and just stare at me. The meat rack. There's fountains here. Oh shit. Not even in the right area. Let's head on back. He knows the dead guy.
Anything I should
this
know about
for you?
I have no idea who's shooting. Rooks.
Someone's up to no good.
Can you please cut this bullshit out? I'm trying to do a tour of London here. Alan has sideburns, Alan has mutton chops. That one's clean shaven. You don't really see people with full-on beards, even though they were around in this time. Good going, Evie, ruining their fun. My rooks are such assholes. I've seen that particular animation before. Oh, sweet nighttime London. Good spot for nighttime London somewhere here. Let's see if I can find it. I might be in a different borough. Some registry. Hmm. insurance office, be prepared for the worst.
Until then, I need your help to raise some money. Can you do that for me?
Yes, Mum.
That's a good boy. Now dry those eyes and hold out your hands.
They're a penny. A penny for me and my mum.
Can anyone spare a penny? You hate me? Something to feed my child?
Sorry, dude. Because it's night, there's no one working here.
I won't check the list one more time. It's not here.
All right, Michael.
We've heard that one before. For fuck's sake, Rooks. Goddamn time in the regular game, there's like blighters swarming Rook territory and they don't do diddly dick. Now that I want a calm, uneventful playthrough where I'm just walking around through London, these assholes decide it's a great time to start gang wars in the streets.
First you cut off the head, and then you wait for all the blood to dry out.
I don't have the stomach. Fine, the way
simple dissection.
I apologize, sir.
Take a look around you.
Get to work.
Right away. The way they are.
What about her? She could be prime minister.
Sometimes it takes a few tries.
Go on. Patience, you're embarrassing me.
I'd vote for you.
I've heard both of those.
Shoulder to the wheel. One more wealthy man, but if he's upon a plan, will render me as happy as a king. And if you will me allow, I will tell it to you now. The time, you know, is always on the wing. And it's worth all his work and be contented. As long as you have enough to buy a meal. Oh. Ah, man, you may be lost.
Dash this summer guitar.
I think bench lovers are just gonna have the same voice clips.
My lead at all times.
Here, boss. Here you go, Chief.
Good work.
We'll go back here. We're pretty much heading in the wrong direction, so let's go over here. Has it ever been discovered what the red arrows indicate?
It's complicated.
Doesn't have to be.
Can you almost see what's happening?
That's enough. I challenge
you. Another sign of shit is going to
the bloody dogs.
Common rugby player.
Tolerant.
Not what you said on our wedding day.
Are you taking his side?
No, I'm about to kick his arse.
Get out of it. You're
so typical of the lower classes.
I can't see a thing.
You're too dear. What is it?
What in the blazes was that for?
It's a disgrace, that is. Just a bloody disgrace.
I say, stop us at once.
It's just
this guy's just trying to juggle here, and everyone around him is arguing. Poor guy.
S for you. Thanks.
Can you offer better?
This is what you need,
no, you can't.
Thank you.
So is what we do. You distract him with some flashbangs
on this one.
To do any work without an oak and surface on which to write my memoir.
Any goings on?
There you go.
Nice work.
Dear, my arm is tingling.
You tried that on the first carriage ride we shared. Do you remember?
She's hiding. Why is she hiding?
Hmm.
That's not
that lot. But I didn't think they'd get John killed.
Wait, where the fuck did he go?
If the time ever came, I would lay down my life for you.
Do you really mean that, my love?
More than you'll ever know.
name. And it's true, he threw it right in the mud. And he just scarred
me.
But you can still see it. I've got the marks all over my trousers.
And he bit you on the leg.
He most certainly did, right here behind my name.
He looks dreadful.
No, you'll be fine.
That's easy for you to say.
Don't worry, he'll be fine.
Let me have a look, Ben.
See, you see?
I've seen much worse than that.
If it's not cleaned properly, a wound like that could fester.
Now, don't go worrying too much again. And it's true, he threw it right in the mud. And he just scarred me.
Goodness.
That's it.
Go, the horse is on display.
Go on.
Push him right against the wall.
Here now.
I guess I can't.
Move back! Come on! Atta girl. So I'm gonna continue down this way and then head down this way, I think. So let me actually mark that area there. Yes, I understand, game. The train safe is full. There's not really any use for the money now. Somewhere.
Dead as it can.
guineas, hey, hey. Look at me
it's
when I talk.
It's his word against you.
You come up with the money, or I'll hang out.
One from Workers of the World Unite to a Union Breaker. This building here is pretty cool.
No, 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 no! I'm here for your benefit! Save yourself time and money!
Enough. I'm a man of the cloth. My brother is wasting away in Lambeth Asylum without cause.
We'll get him released, I promise you that.
He's my brother too.
I'll have me money back, you thief.
You made a wager and you lost. Now be a big boy and come to terms with that fact.
Go on, pike it.
You're both paid. She's our queen.
It was all in fun, sir.
That joke was as good as treason in my book.
Your book isn't law.
Go to hell. See here, I'm about ready to throw myself off one of these buildings.
That's hardly necessary, Adam.
How can you say that?
I'll have me money back, you thief.
You made a wager and you lost. Now be away.
John is to me. Now, James, there must be something, anything in the law that allows me a divorce while maintaining my reputation.
I'm sorry, it's impossible.
Is it?
I can't tolerate this any longer, David. We must free June from that abusive monster. Law be damned.
Agreed. There's no way for June's reputation to be left unscathed unless she's deserted.
What?
If June were to claim cruelty, she would need firm evidence to support her claim. And in all likelihood, even then, she would still not be granted a divorce.
On top of desertion, we all know that John will not leave of his own volition. Perhaps he might arrange for John to desert his sister.
Oh, Lord.
June, I know you detest violence, but I can see no other way to help you. I'm sorry.
However John deserts is none of my concern. In my opinion, there is no other way forward, June.
I understand.
David, I think we can agree this conversation has never taken place. I wish you luck.
Lies can be found.
Now, I may have found us a way to get us out of this jam we're in.
What is it?
If we can convince John that June had been unfaithful, then he would petition for a divorce. Simple as that. And she would be free.
Convincing is not enough. He must prove her to be unfaithful.
Oh, come off it.
You know it's true. The court won't believe it without evidence. June, tell you agree with me.
It doesn't matter. I won't ruin my good name. I don't care how awful John is to me. Now, James, there must be something, anything in the law that allows me a divorce while maintaining my reputation.
These streets aren't safe at night. Mima saw a man get pinked over a locket he found in the mud.
Was it even a nice locket? Bunch of savages.
Does it matter? This thuggery is mad. These streets aren't safe at night.
They are. So I'll make
John will not leave of his own volition. He might arrange for John to desert his sister.
Oh, Lord.
June, I know you detest violence, but I can see no other way to help you.
Sorry.
Sorry. However John deserves is none of my concern. My opinion.
Wait, what?
Lies can be found.
Now, I may have found this way to get us out of this jam.
Now I go.
All right, just stop. I don't want any more of this. You don't make it any worse. Just please stop.
Take a look around you. Are things really fine the way they are?
What about her? She could be Prime Minister.
Go on. You're embarrassing me.
Well, hurry up.
What is it?
Oh, the editor does have a knack for a clever turn of phrase.
An excellent piece.
Yes, the author makes several good points. It certainly cuts to the heart of the matter. Oh, I'm delighted you agree.
You're embarrassing me.
Reading the latest Garfield strip. It's right.
Off of your head.
Immediately, sir.
First, you cut off the head, and then you wait for all the blood to drain out.
Please don't say
that,
sir.
What's out of the
hands? The does have a knack.
Right. Get to work, then.
Unfortunately, it doesn't look like I'm able to get back into the bank.
I'm a man of the cloth. This is a ridiculous charge.
The woman knows what she's doing.
Heard that one before.
He's moss on your car.
I will do what.
Literally unplayable.
Counting on you, Nance. Can't do it without you. Isn't that right, Samuel?
Ah, oh, we need all the manpower we can get.
And woman power.
need all the manpower we...
As long as you're by my side.
There, there, my dear.
No, you don't understand. I knew those fighters were a bad lot, but I did not think they'd get John killed.
I promise you that.
I knew those fighters were a bad lot, but I didn't think they'd get John killed.
Still not be granted a divorce.
Talk of desertion.
These streets are safe at night. Bimar saw a man get pinked over a lock.
I understand. David, I think we can agree this conversation is now.
It looks like this is all going to be the same stuff.
There must be some explanation. How on earth is he still employed?
Blind luck.
He's gonna get someone killed.
He nearly did already. I've half a mind to drag him out and thrash some sense into him. That's what they said to him.
Well, now, I think someone of their stature would say that.
There must have been a reason. Yes, exactly. Their stature.
I saw them.
They wouldn't behave like that.
He said that he felt like he was Atlas, asked to hold up the whole world. He's mad.
It's odd, I'll grant you.
There must be some explanation.
German name.
I see.
It's really as simple as that.
Shouldn't you be at home with her then?
No, she's not there anymore.
Congratulations.
How wonderful.
I think I'll take to fatherhood like a duck to water.
What's that you said?
That's not to say you both have bad names.
We're proud of our names.
But a good English name.
Thank you.
But Helga wants the child to have a German name.
I see.
It's really as simple as that.
Shouldn't you be at home with her, then?
No, she's not there anymore.
Oh, no. Mr. Stevens is an honest businessman who keeps clean books. Mm. And now you're coming up with all these mealy-mouthed excuses. 10 guineas by tomorrow, I'll cut up the ball.
Does this just teleport down here? Like...
How dare you come into my shop pissed as a rat? Consider yourself barred.
Did she stutter?
You've lost yourself a customer. You have nothing to say now. It's too late for that.
You're scaring her, sir.
He just walks away.
Affected by madness.
It happened right in front of me.
Oh.
This one's brown.
Saw a murder.
What's she playing a game?
He's going 19 to the dozen.
Is that a corpse?
Just seen someone get killed.
Horrifying to say the least.
Murder!
One more for the pauper's pit.
There's been a murder!
Why are you running?
What's going on?
Mind you, I
heard
the bank with money in the College of Medicine. I'd like to say you both have bad names.
We're crazy.
Shopkeep. But someone dropped their umbrella.
Rush it, wait till he's alone. When he is, we'll make the bastard pay.
Is everything all right?
There's no need to get carried away.
Well done.
Darling, darling, look!
Well, that is surely the most peculiar thing I've ever seen.
Some sort of political protest, I imagine. What? That's absurd. What could they be protesting? Irish Home Rule?
Don't be so absurd. Can you bloody believe that?
Not half. Darling, darling, look!
You're a dead woman!
Turn around and have a nice bloody stay!
Run up!
What are these people's problem? I'm just trying to find a good pub.
never disappoint. I'd die of shame if I left a woman in your beauty unsatisfied. What do you say?
You have my attention.
You know, I never disappoint. I'd die of shame if I left a woman in your beauty.
Oh,
where's the nearest haberdasher?
It's just over
there,
sir.
Over there?
Yes, sir.
Good.
What is going on? Stop this at once!
The very notion that a person of my status could be accosted in this manner.
The indignity. So unjustly. This city needs
the behavior is quite unbecoming.
I say, we pass the keys from the Bell household to Mr. Stack.
Somebody stop that impetuous beard.
I knew I should have stayed in bed today, but no, the bed won't buy itself.
I swear.
Can't, I need more time.
Come off, man.
I won't stand for this. I'll go to the...
Yes, of course.
Here we go.
Good for any game at night, boys.
Asked to hold up the whole world. He's mad.
And who are you when you're at home?
There must be some explanation.
Yeah, but this is a nightmare. How do I... Where can I go?
Is he still employed?
Who do you think you are?
And who are you? I'm leaving and going back in. I'll solve it.
Let's not draw any attention to ourselves.
Oh, they're gone. Shit.
He's mad.
Trying to find pub songs to listen to. Marvelous.
What do you
streets aren't safe at night.
And looks like that's it.
Saw a man get pinked over a locket he found in the mud.
I take no care to risk my precious life. I'm chary when danger looms. I'm never. But if I meet a helpless woman or little boys who do no harm, I run them in. I show them my bold gendarme. My fright, there is a cry at night, and a revolver's threatening crack. Yet hurt I might if near a shot, so with dispatch I turn my back. And when the trouble is all over, a ragged boy I see his corpse, and run him in, and run him in, I show the mime of Bojan.
Alright, that's an example of a song based on your targets, where he says, like, I run the mint. It's clearly a song about Twopenny.
From the cobblestones, racing, climbing, blooming fertility, born from secret seeds that were scattered in the night time.
Damn it! But there he was singing London Underground. And I guess that's why everyone was running out, because some rooks got into a fight here. Honestly, that bitch deserved it. Ruining my time listening to songs. Only I can do that. Oh, there's one for Elliot Sin, Pearl Attaway. I don't know if I mentioned that before, as far as... I think they're called murder ballads. Oh, actually, I think over here is a familiar area. Soundtrack for his game was done by, I think his name is Anthony Wintory or something like that. He did the soundtrack for the game Journey, which has an amazing soundtrack. So they definitely made the right choice. I do quite like the London Underground song. Gives you a message and saying, watch it, you!
Thanks.
Man, I've been getting so unlucky with the children lately. They used to give like 5,000 pounds, and now it's like... very rarely they give even 500. It's usually the resources, or... voltaic bombs, smoke bombs, medicines. They don't give weapons. You get those from assassinating blighters and templars, and I think police as well. Actually, we might as well see what's inside a factory. And we might as well go inside like a rational, civilized human being, rather than like Evie Fry. Oh, there we go.
That's for you. Thanks.
Hey, you know, the game says I killed a civilian, I say I scared a bully. Oh, Thames is basically... we're gonna continue on.
Are you well? Are you too? Well done.
Oh, really? Which one?
Oh, you cheeky bugger! I'll get you for that.
Fascinating.
Doesn't look like there's any music in here, just a bunch of dudes trying to get laid. Good luck, boyos. Services.
Thank you.
Too. I think that second one might have been another murder ballad. I can't exactly guess who it's supposed to be about. I'm going to guess it might be the first burrow boss killed on top of the train, maybe. But again, I do not know for certain if it even really is one. we started off on this skirmish through the city of London. I think this will be a good time to call it the end. This has been another tour of the London. This time one of the boroughs, the City of London. Again, not a very exciting series of videos, but it is nice to see some of this stuff up close. The details and animations and voice clips that weren't really represented well, just rushing through the game and doing all the missions. So I hope you enjoyed it, and that's about it for now. Next episode we're going to be going to Southwark, so take care.